I have no magical abilities. I am just exactly what you see today. A mother, a woman dressed in some old yellow curtains. I cannot predict the future. Indeed, my Lord has forbidden me to even try. As the occult, in all of its forms, is banned to Christians. All I know is what my Lord chooses to reveal to me through his book and from direct revelation as I talk with him every day. God has shown me very clearly the wickedness of Richard Gardner and Ralph Underwager, who have been used to champion the cause of those who want to legalise paedophilia in this country. Make no mistake, there are people in this country who want paedophilia to be legal. God has shown these things to me, and I have shared these things with you. He has promised that goodness will be rewarded and wickedness will be punished. This is not just wishful thinking, it is a promise. Wicked people are worshipping Moloch at San Francisco. Moloch is the owl demon mentioned in Leviticus 20. In this book. They were murdering infants in the time of Moses, in the same way as they are doing right now in the Bohemian Grove. They are putting babies to death in their vile sacrificial rites. Is this where some of the forced adoption babies have ended up? Sadly, I fear that this may well be so. Many of the people who are attending these infanticides clearly have no idea that they are witnessing genuine murders. That ignorance will not save them from the wrath that is to come. We all know that there is to be a tremendous earthquake in San Francisco. It is common knowledge all over the world that this is imminent. Do you suppose these wicked people will take heed and turn away from their vile sins? I doubt it. They are arrogant and blind. They assume that God is dead. They do not understand the great love of God for the human race. God saw every single person on earth as a little baby. How it must grieve him to see people grow up and commit infanticide in this cold-blooded, sickening manner. God is slow to anger, but when he does become angry, well, I think it's best not to make him angry. Sometimes, like Jeremiah, I feel frightened. I expect you all feel frightened at times too. Sometimes it all seems too big, and I wonder what on earth am I doing here? I'm just a middle-aged woman dressed in a pair of curtains. I'm just a single mum. I'm just a sexual abuse victim. I'm just a rape victim. I'm just a person who didn't even finish my education. I'm just a midget compared to these giants. It is then that I remember how David, and you can read about him in this book, a lonely, unarmed young shepherd boy, defeated a mighty armed giant and began the process of overthrowing the Philistines, a race incidentally who indulged in child sacrifice. David defeated this fearsome giant using nothing more than a homemade sling and a pebble from a stream. He defeated this giant because he had God on his side, as we do. We have God with us. We must listen to what he tells us to do, because the victory is ours for the taking. We have to uncover the cockroach's nest by exposing it to the lights. We will defeat our giant, the paedophile ring that is defiling our land, with no earthly weapon at all. Our only weapon will be the truth, the light that shines into all the dark corners, which the slime, which comes from the devil, cannot stand against. Finally, I would like you all to join me in a declaration. This has become one of my favourite Bible verses, and I hope we can hold it up as a banner to these corrupt secret family courts which have given us all so much pain. It is from Proverbs 18, verse 5. It is not good to be partial to the wicked, or to deprive the innocent of justice. Thank you.